So in one of your talks regarding hormone therapy, you mentioned weight training. And basically, this person would like to know, is there a certain recommended set of exercises?
It seems that anything that builds up the muscles, increases muscle mass, is useful. And traditional approaches that were used by the people at Muscle Beach down in Venice to do multiple repetitions, to go through every area of the body, to increase the muscle size in the legs, the core, the torso, the arms, is most desirable. The protocols that are used vary from center to center, but any good trainer would be able to teach the type of weight training that is going to be useful. And so people that are interested in pursuing this, and I recommend that everyone over age 50 be on some sort of a strength training protocol, should think about hiring a trainer for a month or two to go through the motions and learn the proper techniques and the different types of exercises that are useful in this regard.
So this patient has metastatic prostate cancer. They had one lesion discovered on the bone. It was treated with radiation and they're on hormone therapy. They have recently started a vegan diet and they would like to know if fasting or intermittent fasting would be a good consideration to slow the cancer progress.
Can't say that I've seen any research on that, but it does make sense that because we know that people that eat more restricted vegan diets, macrobiotic diets, can definitely slow cancer progression. So would more extreme dietary practices also slow progression? Quite possibly. One of the things with fasting is that how people come out of their fast is sometimes worse than what they're doing when they're fasting. So I think it's more of a sustained nutritional program than just brief bursts of good nutritional practices. I would think it'd be more important in terms of the long-term plan rather than a short-term plan.
That makes a lot of sense. I know we have a couple videos of Dr. Moyad talking about it, but he's always talking about the diet you can sustain is the healthiest diet for you. And I think that a lot of times when we, especially you see helpline patients come in or, questions like this, they're always thinking of what's a quick solution. And a lot of times it's really, well, prostate cancer is more of a chronic disease, especially when you're taking treatments and you need to be thinking about your diet as helping treat a chronic disease in a prolonged state. Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five, can you high-five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, pcri.org.